is not enough to be busy, so are the ants. And the question is, what are they busy about? And my answer to that question was a statement, and I just wrote, good question. Very good question. But these are, I like this one, is what is your superpower? I didn't answer that one yet. I have to figure out what my superpower is. There are other questions like, why do we take ourselves so seriously? There are cute pictures like upside down sneakers. And what is so unique about me? Some people wouldn't call it unique. But yeah, there are some unique things about everyone. And most times, unless they're harmful to you or other people, you shouldn't change those unique things. Like, you should keep them and enjoy them. What is on your adventure list? Okay, so I've had something on my adventure list for probably about 10 years. I'm getting better, though, because I've accomplished some of them. But I wrote it here. I'm like, remember to go to this place, go to this place, go to this place, and I still haven't gone to this place. It's called the TikTok Clock Museum, or maybe it's just called the Clock Museum. And that's on my adventure list. And I'd like to go back to Ephrata, or Ephrata, and a friend of mine have had this argument, discussion, conversation for 30-something years. It's like pronounced Ephrata. I say Ephrata. She says Ephrata. I'm like, I like Ephrata. Wait, it, or was it the other way around? I don't know. We'll just say another visit to Pennsylvania, that particular town. And I'd like to have the book published. The name of the book that I'm working on, and I have half of it written, is Be Like Kale. Yeah, go figure. I'll tell you more about that another time. Write to me and I'll let you know about that. There's a calendar in here. There's a thing in here. Well, what should you spend time doing? So it really is a book of self-exploration and wonderful pictures by this wonderful photographer or by this person who takes wonderful pictures. I don't know if she's a wonderful photographer. So we got the Clock Museum, the Chick-fil-A, which I've actually gone to, which I intend to go back again to. They do have the best breakfast in a bowl, I'll tell you. And the Healing Garden. I went to the Healing Garden about 10 years ago. It's in New York. And I like to go back there in warm weather. And a few other places. So if you could have only 5 possessions for the rest of your life, what would they be? And draw them here, which of course I don't follow directions. I wrote them there. I didn't draw them there. Think about this. If you could only have 5 possessions your whole life, for the rest of your life, only 5, well, okay, that's 10. I always want more than I'm given, right? 5 possessions for your whole life, what would they be? What would they be? I only listed 4. I couldn't think of 5. I listed 4. Let me see. Are they good enough to read? I don't know. I don't think I'll read them. Let me see. Da-da, da-da, da-da. This is a good table topics question. This really is a good question. I listed 4. And I think I'll do a whole show on that. If you could have only 5 possessions for the rest of your life, what would they be? Write to us at books.musicreview@gmail.com. Tell us what you would choose as your 5 top possessions to have for the rest of your life. And maybe we'll read it on air. Let us know if you want us to read it on air with your name or without your name. So send us that. We'll put the email on the screen later. That's a really good question. I think I have really good answers, but I got 4. I have to think of a 5th one. So 5, I need a bookmark. Or you want to know what my 5 possessions are that I want only for the rest of my life? Next book. This is a really great book. I only got 9 minutes left. Oh, more wood carvings. This is so cool. I'm going to bring it to the camera. Maybe I'm even going to put the close-up camera on it. No, maybe. I don't know. Good time to go out and check the level, see how my voice is coming across on this microphone, which I'm not used to, and it's like, okay, still coming good. Okay, camera, let's see. Nope. Welcome to the books. Oh, I will think I will put the email on now. I do that right? There you go. So, I have a song that I love. No matter what kind of mood I'm in, whether it could be panic, scared, calm, relaxed, excited, upset, there is a song that I love that can just totally change my mood instantly. That's like magic, huh? No, it's better than magic. And that's the song. Oh, wait. Hey, what happened to the close-up camera? That wasn't the close-up. I put the wrong camera on. Hold on. I know what happened. The camera switched when I put the name of the email on. It just switched automatically. So I'm going to switch it back. There's the camera. There's the name. I think that's right. Okay, let's see if I did that right. Or shall I say if I did that correctly, because I know sometimes people don't like me to say the word right. Okay. So I did that correctly, and there's the close-up. Wait. That way? That way. I actually have to go like that. That's the name of the song is It Is Well. Yep. It Is Well. You can hear that song. And if you're in the least bit spiritual, or if you believe in God at all, or if you believe in the promises of the Bible, and you just think about it is well with my soul, that's really the way everything's supposed to be. You know, your world could be falling apart. No, I should have that on there. Like so. Can we do it like that? Oh, now I can't see it because of that. That's better. There you go. So, there you got it. My chest and that. Oh, I get more views now on YouTube. Just kidding. Got to put a little humor in this show. Definitely. And I'm not really that good at telling jokes. So, It Is Well. Can change your mood if you truly, truly believe. Seriously? No matter what is happening, if you just remember that it is well with your soul, you will be okay. And like the chalk walk says, it'll be okay. It'll be okay in the end, you know? And if it's not okay, it's really not the end. So I got to switch screens now and go back so I can finish reading this book, the other book that I didn't even tell you the name of. I have another excellent book. So we're going to switch to, not that one. Whoops. That one. We'll go right back there. 6 minutes. Okay, so the next book, I have to watch that and I have to go put that disclaimer on. There you go. There's our email. Write to us. Write to us. That is that the camera? Write to us with your five things. You're only going to have five things the rest of your life. Now, this is not people, so don't say your family or your kids or anybody. Five things the rest of your life. Things, objects, whatever. So let me know. Now, do we have a guest coming in or not? Good. Okay, not, I didn't mean like that. We're not expecting a guest. It's good that we're not going to be interrupted by a guest. Okay, so now, the name of the book, and I really like this book. I can't say I like every story in the book, but I like this book. This eventually might be one that I'll write for because it's kind of got a style. And yes, it was made available because of the National Endowment for the Arts. I know a lot of people don't agree with that particular organization. However, this is a good magazine. It's called, I read it, lots of it. I don't remember the exact name of them. It has something to do with nonfiction, creative nonfiction writing or something like that. Oh, that's the name of it. It's called Creative Nonfiction. That's it. It's a magazine called Creative Nonfiction. And that's not the cover of it. I just put a book cover on it so that I could read it secretly and nobody should know the name. Sometimes I don't want people to know who the magazine I'm reading. No, it's a good magazine. So the article that I was looking at, there's a couple of them. What I like about it is creative and nonfiction. It's like nonfiction, the truth, and yet creative. A little spin, a little buzz, you know. So the stories in there is, one is completely naked, which I'm sure has nothing to do with nakedness. It is a creative writing professor finds strength in allowing vulnerability. Then there's Daydream Believer Has Lost Her Sense of Wonder, the author. Then there's Hitting the Reset Button, Starting Over. And there's The Wildebeest, or Everything or Nothing, The History of Pain by Schroeder. And Tiny Truths, a collection of Twitter micro essays. So that's a good one. I did get that at a bookstore. You could ask the librarian. And one of the library books I took out was 101 Acrylics, because I can't paint to save my life, but I thought, oh, gee, I could read about it and maybe play with that and have some unfinished acrylic works besides unfinished woodworks. Oh, so what was our show about today? The book, The Most Important Things I Know. I guess I have to go put a disclaimer on there somewhere. I'll put the disclaimer on for a few minutes and then go back to it. Remember what I said. The motto of our show used to be, way back in Brooklyn, a B cat, never wait for your ship to come in, row out and meet it. And that's why you need a little rowboat. You need to come to Woodshop and make a little rowboat to remind you to row out to meet the ship. And so if we come in here with an echo, and first we'll take that off the screen, then we'll do that, then we'll do that. So we have a few minutes left, so there you go. And I'm putting that on for 2019 because our copyright is from 2019 and parts of it also from 2018, which is kind of silly because, you know, I think it lasts, a copyright lasts for about like 50 years or something like that. So you really don't need to change the year every year, but I guess you got to listen to regulations. And so that's my copyright. So there you go. There's copyright 2018 as regulated and 19 as, that's the way I like it. Okay, so what am I doing? I never said I knew what I was doing. So here we go. So we got 2 minutes left, and I'll come back and put that copyright thing on again. The produce through, because we all know where it's produced through. And I might even just put this up to the camera. Is it that camera? No. Is it that camera? It's that camera. There's a bird for my dad and my grandpa. It's my unfinished wood project. It's just a little drawing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to burn it in. It's called pyrography. Yeah, so we do a little bit of pyrography. And it's fun. It's kind of really fun. Oh, and I did this other one. What do they call it? A non-politically correct wood project.